One of the questions we wanted to understand is how come some patients respond well to chemotherapy and other patients don't respond well to chemotherapy. And it turns out that when the bad leukemia cells are killed by chemotherapy, they do it via this process that's called apoptosis. It turns out that cells have ways of actually committing suicide when they are detected to have absorbed a lot of damage. And it turns out that some leukemia cells are very close to the threshold of committing to this kind of cell death, and some are very far away. I just mean at the beginning, before they've even seen any therapy. And it turns out the ones that make sense, the ones that are really close to the threshold, really close to the edge, are the ones that end up being killed more readily by chemotherapy, which is good. The ones farther from the edge are harder to kill with chemotherapy, and that makes treatment more difficult. From a clinical point of view, I think we have the potential to make use of this by actually using some of the tools we developed in answering these basic questions to study samples from patients and make predictions about how they're going to respond to different therapies so that we can better assign therapy as patients progress through their treatment. The next step is to actually get an independent set of patient samples and test much more specifically exactly this question. So get like 100 patient samples and say, can we predict the ones that really needed allogeneic bone marrow transplant, separate from the original, you know, set of samples that we already used in this study? If that bears out, then it'll be time to really try to design a clinical trial where we are going to assign therapy based on this new biomarker.